Nev and Courtney, I have a question for you first. What is something that has stayed consistent working with Wes and now with Matt and Tyler? And then also, what's something unique about Matt and Tyler that you think served this fifth film well?
Well, I mean, the fact that Matt and Tyler claimed they learned to direct from watching Wes's movies and became directors because of him and directed their first film based on the Scream movies, Ready or Not, you know, that lent itself to them continuing in Wes's energy, you know what I mean? And I think they've done a beautiful job. It feels seamless. And yet at the same time, they're gorier, which you can see in Ready or Not, and they brought that to this film. But it's got all the humor, it's got all the scares, it's got the suspense, it's got the fun. I mean, they did it. I mean, they really, hats off to them. I think they did a great job.
Absolutely. Another question for the both of you, because I've heard a lot about how Wes really believed in his actors in the many, many interviews I watched about this franchise over the years. So do either of you have an example of a time on the previous four films where he really believed in something that was creatively important to you and you think made that scene better in the end?
Well, I will say that Wes was always making the scenes better. I mean, we were listening to David the other day, and he came up with the ice cream scene when the guy was smoking a cigarette, the cop opposite him,
and Dewey's,
and Dewey's mm-hmm. pretending it's his cool, it's his cigarette. Wes was really funny. So I think he trusted us for sure. He always cast people that, you know, were dedicated and knew their characters and, you know, but I think that he always added to every scene, every part, more than anything.
I would believe
and,
that.
And Matt and Tyler, you know, yeah. I think do the exact same. They added so much to every scene for sure.
All right, Melissa. So I believe this is your first horror movie. So what is it about what it takes to make a bloody slasher movie that felt different and maybe surprised you compared to some of the other genres you've worked in?
What was so surprising was that it was the most fun I've ever had shooting anything. Like, you're shooting something where you're constantly screaming and, like, you know, acting scared, but behind the scenes, we were all laughing and having the absolute best time, covered in like syrupy blood, all sticky. We couldn't like grab anything because we would stain everything. So that's a level of like patience and, you know, I don't know. It's a skill in itself being able to like be like that, but it was so fun. It was just, I didn't expect it to be as fun as it was.
Kind of reflects the viewer experience too. It's genuinely scary, but for some inexplicable reason that I haven't been able to put into words all these years later, I have fun and I love it. So yeah. Job well done in that respect. In order to steer clear of Scream 5 spoilers right now, I'm going to look back a little bit. Nev, I've always wondered, how much has the killer reveal from Scream 3 influenced your portrayal of Sydney in Scream 4 and now this movie? Because, you know, who he is and what he did kind of rocks the foundation of the character a little.
What happened?
I just had the bangs.
Remind me.
It's Roman. It's your brother.
Oh, right.
Well, the thing is with Sydney, she's pretty much lost anyone she's ever loved. So I don't think it has to be any one family member or boyfriend or friend. I mean, they all get killed. So pretty much just stay away from Sydney.
I adore every single movie in this franchise, and I mean it, but I feel like that was the right answer.
Thank you.
One more question looking back for you that I don't even know if you know the answer to this, but it's a debate I find myself having often, and I seem to be in the minority on this matter. The scene in the bathroom from the original film where Sydney's attacked, did Wes ever tell you if that ghost face was Billy, Stu, or a prankster?
Ooh. He did not tell me, because there would be no reason for me to know, because then that would just, you know, then she knows who the killer is and then it takes you out of the headspace that you need to be in. So no, he did not tell me.
I think it was Stu. I don't know why. I've always thought it was Stu.
I don't think it matters.
Yeah.
Or maybe it does to some people who are online.
I don't know. I've spent too long obsessing over this movie. I feel like I just saw like the color drain from my face.
I don't mean that as an offense. I just mean,
I know.
Never mind.
For what it's worth, Melissa, I agree with you. I'm in the minority. I think it's two.
I think it's two.
I honestly, I've made so many of these. I don't know what you guys are talking about.
No, but I can get into this with you because I think it's too quick of a change for it to be Billy because he was right there.
Okay, I gotcha. You know? All right. So it does matter. And there you go.
It does. And the tone of the scene doesn't feel like prankster. So we've eliminated and we're going with
prankster's out for sure.
Yeah. All right, we're done. As someone who is very clearly obsessed with this franchise and also with her own bangs, Courteney, I have to ask you to do this. Can you please rank Gale's five hairstyles for me?
Well, I thought that four was kind of bland, but I had to change from three. I mean, I had to just do something so I could not feel horrible about myself. I would say the best look probably was the bright orange lipstick and the blonde hair, which I don't look good blonde, but I think the worst was three and four was a little boring, to be honest. But I didn't take that many chances in the relaunch either. No. I should have.
No,
I wore a bright red suit, but she then became, you know, the head of
New York City. Now.
I live in New York. I got a little more sophisticated, although that was really the fun part. What color and what am I going to do?
My personal favorite is two.
You like the red hair or whatever that was?
Two's up there for me. Yeah. All right. I'm going to squeeze this in last because I can't tell if they're going to let me do it or not. But Nev, did you ever work out just for your own head how Sydney and Mark reconnected?
Oh my gosh.
This is really hard questions.
I'm sorry.
These are great questions.
I haven't seen these movies in so long.
Please tell me you know who Mark is.
Tell us. That Mark is Patrick Dempsey.
Yes. Okay. Yes. Yes. You know what's weird? I played his sister in Grey's Anatomy after that. Isn't that weird?
Oh, you did? Yes. That is very weird. Yeah.
So what was the question about Mark?
Well, I think I know the answer now, but if you ever thought through how the two characters reconnected.
Oh yeah. I didn't know whether they would end up like supposed to have a relationship or something, but that, I think that ended up not being the case.
I have to let you go, Melissa. I get to grill you more later. So I'm looking forward to that. Thank you. So like, it doesn't matter if you know all these little details that I've obsessed over my entire life.
We can obsess later.
I look forward to that. The point is you have consistently given me films that bring joy to my life for decades now. And I really appreciate it. This last one means a lot to me. Thank you. And congratulations.
Thank you.